Hello, this is Mark from Excel Off the Grid. In this video, we're looking at the unique function in Excel. If you want to work along with this video, I suggest you download the example file, and there are links and instructions in the descriptions box below. Once you've done that, if you're ready, let's get started. Before we go any further, I just want to remind you to subscribe and get notifications so that you don't miss a single video. I can't even begin to count the number of times I have created a unique list in Excel. I've performed it manually using the Remove Duplicates option from the ribbon. I've performed it with pivot tables and using complex formulas. But now we have a new option, an easier option. When Microsoft announced changes to Excel's calculation engine in September 2018, they also announced a host of new functions, and one of those functions is called Unique. At the time of recording this video, the Unique function is only available to those on a Microsoft 365 subscription, and it won't be available in Excel 2019 or earlier versions. Let's start by briefly looking at how the Unique function works. Unique is one of the new dynamic array functions, which means it behaves differently to most of the traditional Excel functions that we're used to using. So let's start here. In cell G3, Unique, open bracket, I'm just going to select the cells B3 to B10, which is the first name column. Close that bracket, and when I press return, rather than returning a single value, Unique returns many values, and it spills those values into the cells around it. This is what makes it a dynamic array function. Now that we have a basic understanding of how Unique works, let's look at the arguments of the Unique function. Unique has just three arguments, and the last two are optional and actually quite obscure, so you'll only use those occasionally. So we have three arguments here: array, bicol, and exactly once. So array is the range or array to return the values from. This is the range that we are assessing. Bicol, this is an optional argument where false means that we compare the data in rows, and true means we compare the data in columns. If it's excluded, the argument will default to false. And we'll see the impact of this decision in example 4 in this video. Exactly once. This argument depends on your interpretation of the word unique. If you want a list that includes only items that appear once, then use true. If you want a list that contains one instance of each item, i.e. a distinct list, then use false. This is an optional argument, and if excluded, it will default to false, which is probably the option we want to use most of the time anyway. And we'll see the impact of this in example 1. So now that we've seen how Unique works from a high level, and we've also looked at the arguments, we're now going to look at 6 examples so we can really get a deep understanding of how this function really operates. So let's start with example 1. In this example, we're really trying to understand the difference between a distinct and a unique list. And for this, we're just going to use the first name column. So here in cell G3, for a distinct list, I'm going to type equals unique, open bracket, select cells B3 to B10, close that bracket and press return. And there we have all the values that occur in our first name column. Now Jack and Chow both appear twice in our first name column. And because we've asked for a distinct list, Jack and Chow just appear once in our list. Now let's compare that with a unique list. So in cell I3, I'll type equals unique, open bracket, I'll select cells B3 to B10, comma, I'll exclude the bicol argument, press comma again. And here we have the option for exactly once, and we can put true or false. Now when we looked at distinct, because we didn't provide an argument for that, it automatically defaulted to false. However, for a unique list, we need to type true in here, because we want only the things that occur exactly once. So I press return, and there you see we get a list of only 4 items. And that's because we're looking at the items that only occur exactly once. So Chow and Jack both occur twice in our source data, which means they are completely excluded from our list. And if you look, Sally, Billy, Ryan and David are the names that occur only once. So to summarise this example, it's important to understand the difference between a distinct and a unique list. When using the exactly once argument, if we have false or don't provide any value for it, it will return a distinct list. If we provide true, then it will provide a list of those items that occur only once. Now my guess is in most situations we're looking for a distinct list, in which case the default options are perfectly fine. Okay, now let's move on to example 2. Now example 2 is here to demonstrate how the unique function responds when it's linked to an Excel table. Excel tables automatically expand or retract depending on the data that's in them. So let's have a look at this. In cell G3, I'm going to type equals unique, open bracket. I'll select cells B3 to B10, but actually that isn't cells B3 to B10. It is the column first from our TBL exams table. I'll close that bracket and press return, and there we get our distinct list. Now, what happens if we add more data into our data table? So I'll select this line here, Dale Taylor, and I'll drag that up to join into our table. And if you watch the result of our unique function, there we have it. Dale is automatically added into our result. And this is because unique is linked to the table. And because tables expand and retract when data is added or taken away, it means the result of the unique function does the same thing. Right, now let's turn to example 3. In this example, we're looking at how we can use unique across two columns. To start with, let's click here in cell G3. We can type equals unique. And actually, we can select two columns of data. So I can go from cell B3 to cell C10. And I close the bracket on that and press return. You'll see that it returns both the columns that we provided in the argument. Now, when we looked at a single column, we only had one instance of Jack in our final result because it was a distinct list. Here, as you see, we have two instances of Jack, and that's because one is Jack Weber and the other one is Jack Wilson. So when we provide multiple columns into the unique function, it combines those together so we get a unique list from both columns. Now imagine that we don't want to have two columns, we just want a single column. So how can we achieve that? So let's click here in cell G3. And we'll go equals unique, open bracket, and we'll select cells B3 to B10, ampersand, and we'll put a space in double quotes, an ampersand, and then select cells C3 to C10. I'll close that bracket, and when I press enter, as you can see, we have the same list, but it's the first name, a space, and then the last name. So we've joined that name together into a single column. Okay, now let's move on to method 3. Method 3 looks at what we do when the columns are not next to each other, but we still want to return multiple columns. So we've got two column headings for method 3. We've got pass/fail and first. So we want our first column returned to be the pass/fail column and the second column to be the first name column. So I'll click here in cell L3 equals unique, open bracket, and we're actually going to use the choose function. We can use choose whenever we want to combine multiple ranges into a single range. So here we go, choose, open bracket, and then an open curly bracket. In this example, we want two columns, the first column, comma, and then the second column, close bracket, and then we enter a comma. And the first range we want to return is the pass/fail column. And put a comma, and then the second range we want to return is the first name column. So we'll select that, we can close the choose, close the unique, and then press return. And as you can see, it now returns a unique list based on both of those columns in the order in which they appear. Right, now let's move on to example 4. By default, Excel assumes that unique should be applied in a vertical list. However, it can also work in a horizontal list. So let's try this. Let's get a list of the unique values from cell D2 to I2. I'm going to start by clicking in cell I3. I'll type equals unique. Open bracket. I'm going to select cells D2 to I2. Press the comma. And then we have the bicol argument. So far, we've not needed this because our data has been arranged in rows. Well, now our data is arranged in columns. So I'm going to enter that as true, close the bracket, and then press return. And as you see, we now have a unique list of February, March, and April. But what if we have data that's arranged in columns, but we want to return it in rows? In that circumstance, we can use the transpose function. So let's go here in cell I3, equals unique, open bracket. I can select those same cells, D2 to I2. The bicol will be true because our source data is arranged in columns. Close that bracket. So to make sure it then comes out in rows rather than columns, I'll enter the transpose function. Open bracket and then close that at the end. Press return, and there we have it. Our result is returned vertically rather than horizontally. Okay, now let's move on to example 5. In this example, we're looking at how we can use unique with other functions, specifically the sort function. So in cell G3, I'm going to type equals unique again. And this time we're going to go last name, comma, first name in a single column. So I'll select C3 to C10, ampersand, comma, space in double quotes, and ampersand, and select the first name. If I close that, that will provide a unique list with last name, comma, first name. But what if I want this list to be sorted in alphabetical order? Well, I can wrap that in the sort function. Now, there's lots of arguments in the sort function, but the purpose of this video is to focus on the unique function. So we're just going to use a very basic version of sort. And that just has one argument, which is the range to be sorted. So when I press return on that, we now have our unique list in alphabetical order. Often the reason we want this kind of list is because we want to use it in a data validation list. So let's have a look at how we could apply that. So here in cell L3, I'm going to click that, then click data, data validation, and then data validation again. For allow, I'm going to select list, and then in source, I can select cell G3 and then press a hash. And what that means is it will include all the cells from that function that start in cell G3. So G3 and all of its spill range. So I'll click OK on that. And now when I click on the dropdown, as you can see, we have our unique list in alphabetical order, and we can select those as a standard data validation list. Right, it's now time for our final example, example 6. And here in this example, we want to create a simple pivot type report where we count the number of passes or fails for each month. So let's start here in cell G3. Type equals unique, open bracket, and we'll select the cells E3 to E10. So that's the list of pass or fail. And I press return on that. Unsurprisingly, we get pass and fail as the two options there. Then across the top, we want the months. So I'll select here, cell H2 equals unique, open bracket. I'll select cells D3 to D10. Close that bracket, but because I want it ordered horizontally, I'll wrap that in a transpose function. And press return on that. So that means we've now got the headings for our simple pivot report. I'll enter COUNTIFS. Open bracket. And our first criteria is whether it's a pass or a fail. So I'll select the cells E3 to E10, comma. And this is where it equals cell G3. But I want the entire range that is resulted from that function. So it'll be G3 hash. And as you can see, that now picks up G3 and G4. Next, I want to pick up the exam date. So I select cells D3 to D10. And the criteria I want to match that against is where it equals the month. So there we have, I've selected cell H2, but again, I want the entire spill range of H2. So I press hash. And as you can see, those additional cells of March and April have been added into that range. I'll close that formula, and when I press return, fantastic. There we have it, a simple pivot report. So from three functions, we've been able to create our horizontal and vertical axis for our report and also filled our values. Well, that's it for me today. I hope this video has given you a really good introduction to understanding how Unique works. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll catch you next time.